Hello, Cloud Gurus, and welcome back to another AWS This Week, where we find out what goodies AWS have announced in the past 7 days. I am your friendly neighborhood Jess Alvarez, and this week, App Runner now supports CDK for building and deploying applications, Step Functions workflows now supports PrivateLink, and Internet of Things device management is now supported on CloudFormation. Stay tuned to hear the full story in this episode of AWS This Week. Earlier this week, AWS announced that App Runner now supports using AWS Cloud Development Kit, or CDK, to build and deploy your applications. AWS App Runner is a fully managed and auto-scaling service that allows for quick deployment of containerized web applications and APIs at scale. The AWS CDK is your single launch source using languages like Python and Node.js. You can now create App Runner resources by specifying a source code location like Amazon Elastic Container Registry, or ECR, public and private, or GitHub in the service construct of the CDK. You can also specify the IAM roles those resources need to use using the CDK. I have included a link to the developer guide for more information on this new functionality. AWS Step Functions Synchronous Express Workflows now support PrivateLink. This update now allows your workflow to start from your VPC without having to traverse the public internet space. Step Functions helps you to build distributed applications, automate processes, and build machine learning pipelines with quick responses and without the need to pull additional services or create custom solutions. Now with PrivateLink support, you can connect private connections between VPCs, AWS services, and on-premises networks to reduce the risk of DDoS attacks or man-in-the-middle attacks. You will need to create a new VPC endpoint to connect to Synchronous Express workflows, but no code changes are required for your SDK configurations as long as you have private DNS resolution enabled in the VPC and VPCE. Make sure you check the complete list of supported regions for your use case before attempting to implement this new offering. Internet of Things users, lend me your ears. IoT Device Management is now supported on CloudFormation. With just a few clicks, you can use a CloudFormation template to pre-configure and deploy IoT fleet management infrastructure. This means that your job templates, fleet metrics, IoT logging settings, can now all be standardized and replicable across regions and AWS accounts. Need to deploy new IoT fleet management resources? Use a JSON file to do it, and voila! Easy peasy, rice and cheesy. Your resources are deployed using CloudFormation. Always make sure the region you need for your use case is supported before attempting to use this great new hotness. We're gearing up for AWS reInvent from November 29th through December 3rd. Stop by our booth number 1561 to meet me and some of your favorite training architects, get some cool free swag, play some games, and maybe even get a photo with us. If you don't have a chance to be there in person, make sure to join our awesome Discord community where you can hang out with all of your favorite AWS training architects and like-minded people. Well then, I hope you enjoyed this episode of AWS This Week. I've included links in the resources to cover all the fancy smanchy new things we covered today. And remember that we do have a free plan offering here at A Cloud Guru. This is perfect if you're someone who likes to try before you buy. We include a bunch of free courses each month so you can see if A Cloud Guru is right for you. We've included the sign up link below. Thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time. Bye.